What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harshvardhan Pratap Singh Rana.
And I am Shreyas Muncher.
Jai Harivat.
What are we doing today, Bhatia?
We're doing Leila. It's Leila.
Cool.
So yeah, what do we know about Leila?
Leila is the latest series on Netflix.
Huma Qureshi.
Yes.
Yeah, so lots of expectations from this in terms of like Huma Qureshi, Netflix. Yep. And what we know is like it's like in the near future world.
Yeah.
It's very like Hitler-like. There's some pure blood stuff going on and cleansing and purity and stuff. Super controlled, no place for emotions and stuff like that. Probably
no art, no music, no literature, nothing of that sort allowed. This is equilibrium dubbed in Hindi. That's what you guys should be expecting. That's what we got to know from the synopsis and from the trailers.
Right. Very promising.
Yeah, it was. I was really thrilled for this. I was really looking forward to it, especially knowing that Huma Qureshi, I really like her as an actress.
Right.
And whenever she's on screen, I'm generally just gravitating towards her character and, you know, I'm grasped.
Right.
So, yeah, I was really looking forward to this. Let's just dive into the goods. First and foremost, the first thing that stood out to me, I think even before the series came out, even from as soon as we saw the trailers, it was the concept.
Just the concept.
I was very interested because Indians don't have too many shows that depict the future, depict a dystopian future.
This controlled propaganda state stuff.
Exactly.
Right?
So it's very interesting.
Yes.
I was really thinking about the things that you could have done with it.
Right.
But the key terms being could have.
Emphasis, right?
Exactly.
Right.
Some of the characters are characters
for
I really enjoyed.
For sure. And I mean, minus, I think, Huma. Sort of character building up and then we don't know where she goes from there, but the side characters, Rahul Khanna's
fantastic.
He's really cool.
He's very charming in this.
Absolutely, And then Siddharth also, besides the main protagonist.
Who you guys
like,
might know from Rang De Basanti.
Absolutely, yeah. So he's also really something's up.
And they're fantastic actors across the board. This entire series is sprinkled with really, really good actors.
Correct. Yeah. And it's relatively well shot, like you said, with Netflix, and we can't really expect this. So we haven't seen this much with Bollywood, right?
Exactly. With Bollywood cinema and the kind of CGI that they've implemented here and there. Exactly. It's not bad. Sometimes it's a little noticeable, but overall I think this is a very good attempt at merging Bollywood with CGI and all that.
So yeah, definitely stuff to look forward to. Good concept, good cast, there's a decent build up, and that's as much as we could squeeze out of this, right?
Jai The bad.
Oh god.
Jai.
First and foremost, the characters, like we already said, though the acting's good,
and
some of them
so much of a build up, but they just fall flat.
So many characters, you think there's so much that can happen with them, they can go in so many directions. The first two episodes set them up so well, they go nowhere. The character arcs are so unfulfilling.
Yeah, I mean, their motivations, the decisions they make, like. There's so much of build-up, but they're not linear at all. Some of the decisions they make, like, it just doesn't make
sense. They go nowhere. Huma Qureshi, I was so disappointed in because generally when she's on screen, I really latch onto her as an actor.
Yes.
Here, in parts, she was outstanding. In parts, I was baffled. I was like this is not the same actor that I know. So she seems completely out of her depth in some of the scenes, some of the episodes.
Right.
Because I think the character is supposed to come across as a little confused, who doesn't know what to do, how to proceed.
Yeah, it's sometimes you empathize with her, sometimes you feel for her, but sometimes you're so disconnected, it's like, what's going on? And the rest of the stuff doesn't really help to like compensate for
So, I totally agree with that. And say firstly, like we already said, the concept is amazing.
But execution is...
It's flat. Like at the end of the day, it all does come down to the execution of how the set, you know...
Exactly. So what is that? Like poor writing, poor directing. Like some of it was just like too random, man. It just didn't make sense. It almost like...
Some of this dystopian world just pissed the shit out of me, man. Like there were times when just Jai Arivat. I think there's Jai Arivat in this entire series about 500 times in just 6 episodes. The entire dystopian world makes no sense. You're just dropped into it.
Yeah.
You know, nothing is explained to you.
So
you're really left, you know, reeling in what's happening and, you know, what's going on. You're just grasping and trying to make sense of whatever's thrown at you from the screen.
Yeah. Okay, that's it. Calm down. Let's like, easy. Take a breath. Jai Arivat.
I think let's do more of this. Let's get into Filmy.
Okay. Cool. So Filmy, man. I mean, I don't know. I mean, okay, so you're put into this future world, like near future world, but there's no explanation of what's happened, why it's happened, yeah. what the sort of controls are around.
Right. Even the segregations, the rules, none of it is explained.
Yeah, they just mention as categories, and right. we know that Muma's a category 5, and we don't know the significance of
it. And literally, water is gold.
Yeah.
That's all we know.
Right. I mean, yeah, like we said, concept is good. So, yeah, the next world war we think will be based on water.
Water,
but,
probably, yeah.
Yeah, here they just show like a water shortage. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's it. And apart from that, like you already said, the execution is horrible for this. Like, the character arcs, the writing, the overall narrative of the entire series,
right.
it just falls flat.
Yeah.
So it's.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you kind of get hooked initially because there's a lot of shit going on and disaster strikes, but yeah, zero explanation. You don't know what's going on, why it's going on. And it's sort of, I think within the later episodes, you realize what you're getting into. And once you realize what you're getting into, you're like, this is crap. Absolutely. It's like a waste. And it just gets worse and worse and worse.
So for the first two series, they do get you hooked.
Yeah.
But this is a 6-part series,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
The way it progresses from there goes nowhere.
Yeah.
After the entire series, I was just feeling why was I following this lady for this entire run of 6 hours?
Yeah, like,
it led to nothing.
Yeah, like literally. He hated it so much. He said in the last few episodes, it's like they just filled in stuff so that they can finish their 40-minute episode.
It's exactly. It's there's so much fluff. There's so much of people going. They have to do this. They have to do that.
Yeah.
She has to go here and do this,
yeah,
which leads to nothing. It's, it's all for nothing.
Yeah.
So all in all, I was really, really left disappointed with this series.
Yeah.
I had really high expectations from this, especially because of Huma Qureshi, Siddharth, Rahul Khanna, the kind of actors that were attached to this. Some of them have done a good job with the material that they were given.
Yeah,
but all in all, this is a very disappointing take by Netflix.
Yeah. You guys should have probably seen Equilibrium 2-3 times.
Yeah.
And then taken some pointers or ripped it off entirely.
500 times better. Yeah.
So I think that's what it meant, Jay Arivat.
Oh, Jay Arivat, let's just get into the ratings, guys. What do we think about this part,
Paul? Huh, cool. Okay, so I don't know, man. I think I was sold into it initially, but then in the end, I was just left like, why did I waste 40 times 6, 4, 6, or 24, 240 minutes of my life?
I couldn't have put any better.
Yeah, and the end, so we're calling this season 1. Is there a second season? I don't know. It's unnecessarily open-ended. So they just had to put that in Nolan-esque, ooh, what happens here?
Yeah.
So I know it's a cluster T, cluster F for me, for sure.
Absolutely, I think I'm going to say the same thing. I am generally a very easy guy to please when it comes to cinema.
It's too easy as an audience.
I have no standards. I'm kidding. But yeah, I'm really easy to please when it comes to cinema, Bollywood, Hollywood, whatever.
Yeah.
But this series just had me on, it just got to me. And there's no way. This is, you can't say something like this. So I'm going to call this a clusterfuck for sure.
Jai Arivat.
Jai Arivat.
Alright, man. Thank you for watching this.
Like, share, subscribe as usual. If you don't, we'll catch hold of you and put you in a prison and we won't give you water.
Yeah.
You know what's gonna happen to you.
And we'll force you to watch this back to back.
Oh, endless loop. Endless loop, yeah, absolutely. So like, share, subscribe as usual. We love you guys. Thank you so much. Jai Arivat.
Thank you so much for watching, man. We're good.
Bad.
And Filmy. And we're going to be doing a lot of stuff like this. Be it Netflix, be it big screen, Hollywood, Bollywood, you name it.
Yeah, MCU, DCU, all of it.
All of it, yeah. So yeah, stay tuned, man. Please like, share, subscribe.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to be doing fun stuff pretty much every week.
We love you guys. Thank you so much for all your love and support. Be back for more.
Yo.